So this is the table which we use to show drill down. So here the data is for the coverage of three vaccines, BCG, DPTB, and HIV and PV for the districts of training land. So what we do is by drilling down is going up and down, basically down the hierarchy in the organic tree. So we can do it easily. We can change the organic dimension, what is here, and also do that. But to make the pivot tables more attractive, we have introduced a drilling down function within the table. So this is currently being developed, and now what we can do is, let's see if we want to see if you, let's go to one district, let's go to fruit district and click one data value, and I want to see this for the facilities of the fruit district. So I want to drill it down within fruit district, not for the whole districts, but only you can do it only one district and drill down to the facility level. So if I click one cell, you get this menu to change org unit. So you can go up to food region, or you can go down to facility level in the fruit district. So if I click facility level, I can see the same data for the facilities in the fruit district. So that is called drilling down. So again, I can go back to district level, but from here you cannot get all the districts. You can go only to the parent district. So you won't be going back to all the district of that training land, but up to fruit district only. So you see data for fruit district. So you can go back drilling facility level, or go up to the district level and again go up to food region and maybe up to national level. Then if you want to drill back again, now you can go to regions, and from one region you can drill back, and then one district up to facility. So that is making the tables more interactive and going up and down. So that is about drilling down. And there was another question about legends. Somebody was asking whether to show, whether we can show how to create legends. Since we have some time, I will go to that. Otherwise, this is coming under design and customization part. So I will just briefly show you how to create a legend. So go to maintenance, app, and in the other group, you have legends here. So you can see the existing legends, the configured legends. There are 26 legends here. And if you want to add, configure more data, configure another legend, simply click this plus button. And this is the interface to create a legend. So you can, you have to give a name. Let's say test legend. You can give a code that is optional. And there are two methods of doing that. One is, there is a method to automatically create the legends. So you give the start value and the end value and the number of legend items, and it, you can automatically create. Let's say we have values from 0 to 1000. And I want maybe nine items, and you can select a predefined color here. So I will select purple one, and you can automatically create the legend items so that the system will create the requested amount of legend items within that range. So 0 to 101, 111 will be this color likewise. So this is created by the system, but still you can change it. You can edit the legend items. You can change the values. You can change the color likewise. So your legend is created here and you can save it. So my test legend is here. You can open it. Legend is created. Now you can apply it. Or else you can do the legend item creation by yourself. You can delete. I'm going to delete all the options. And I'm going to do it manually. So I can add legend items one by one. You can give a name. You can give a start value, end value, and a color. Name first, let's say first start value 0 to 10. My color, I can pick any color. Now I have one value, then I add another value to start value would be 11 to 20. So I give another color. Likewise, you can create your own legend items here and save. So you have to make them or shouldn't have gaps between. So likewise, you can create your own legends with your own colors and save. So that my test legend is here, you can apply it to the tables. That is basically how to create a legend. I'm going to delete this. So those were the questions I saw in chat and Slack. There was another question to repeat how to apply legends. I will do that. I will use the same table. I will change the org units back to districts. Clear the legends for the moment. So this is the table we are going to apply legends. So somebody wanted to know how to apply colors into this table. So we can do that using legends so that we can comprehend the table easily. So for that, we can use a predefined legend, which is available to apply. So you go to options. First, you create the table. Then you go to options. Then legend, tick this display legend button, and first you get the option to apply legend either to background color or text color. I will apply to background color, and then the legend type. You can use predefined legend per data item. That is already we have when we are configuring the data element or the indicator, if we have applied a legend. You can use that, or you can use one legend for all the table, whole table. I'm going to use select a single legend for the entire visualization and select EPI coverage, because I know that how this legend is configured. I know that it's configured from 0 to 100 and color is ranging from green to red. So I'm going to apply it. Now I can see the colors applied with good districts showing in green and bad districts going in red. I can use this color to the text rather than the background, so that text color will change, not the background. So that is how you apply the legend. So if you want to apply a predefined legend item, then in the data element indicator, let's say BCG coverage, there should be a legend applied here. So already we have the API coverage applied. So if you want to use that legend, you can use this option. So you can still, it will come because the legend is already applied while configuring the data indicator. Right. So all these indicators, when we were configuring in the maintenance, legends were applied. So that legend we can use here, or we can use any other legend. I hope that clarifies the queries. And there are no more queries in the Slack or in chat.
Is it possible to apply legend on a data element?
Apply what?
In a data element.
Yes, data element also. I will show if you go to data element. When we are configuring, you can apply a legend when we are configuring here. Or in the table. So instead of using data elements, so instead of using indicators, you can add a data element here and you can apply a legend here. It will apply to whatever there is, depending on the value. Right. So I think that marks the end of the day of on pivot tables. I hope I have tried to go as low as possible and as simple as possible so that you will understand how to use the pivot table and work more on the advanced features by yourself. So we have covered the first main analytic tool in DHIS2, that is pivot tables. So tomorrow we will be doing the charts, and on Monday the maps, and then followed by dashboards and reports. So thank you very much for listening to me, and I hope I have given some knowledge. And please do the graded exercise also. You can start it, and there's a deadline. Please submit it before the deadline. And thank you very much. And that's all from me. And Saurabh or anybody else, if there is anything to add, you can.
Yeah, just a request on filling the feedback form, please. So the number of feedback forms are pretty less if we compare it to the participant count. So if all can take out 5 minutes from your time to fill up the feedback form, it would be really helpful for us. So thank you.
Yes, that is really important for us because we have to know how we did. You can blame me, you can scold me, you can put positives, negatives, anything, and we are open for that. And please put the feedbacks for all the sessions we have done so far, and make sure you do it for the future sessions after those sessions also. So that's it from us. Please do the exercises, practice, and do the graded exercise also. And I wish all of you will get good marks for that. That makes the teacher proud. Thank you very much, and see you tomorrow.